About to enter the famous Selden Park for the 2012 September Poinsett Clark Parade. This is part of the Tunis Campbell Celebration here in Brunswick, Georgia, in the Gullah Geechee Nation, part of the Golden Isles. We marched for this park to make sure that no one would ever forget the story here and that they wouldn't tear down the historic building. There's many lawsuits behind it and everything, and now we're heading back here for the first time since the last time we had a Selden Park rally and march. And so this is going to be the end of the parade, but the beginning of the opening of the Freedom School that's being led by the Reverend Zach Lyde, who's a representative on the Assembly of Representatives for the Gullah Geechee Nation. So Reverend Lyde is a native here in Brunswick who has been continuing to fight to keep the story of our folks alive here in Brunswick and keep people on their land and understanding their true heritage and history, which is why he's the visionary behind this Tunis Campbell celebration. And throughout this episode of Gullah Geechee TV Nation News, you'll learn a lot more about who Tunis Campbell is and why the story of our people is so critical for us to fight for and to hold on to here in Brunswick, Georgia, and especially right here at Selden Park. So, Hunter Chillin, this year the Queen Quet, head from the body of this year Gullah Geechee Nation. So glad that Hunter to tune in one more again to We TV Station, Gullah Geechee TV Nation News. And Hunter Chillin, know this year the what going on.
What ought to happen with us from now on is we take ownership of protecting our kids, save our schools. We need to take ownership of that. And that was the statement y'all made this morning coming down that road. Freedom School, I'm the superintendent of IAM. Mrs. Stella Wright is the chairman of the board. Kabua Dickinson is the president of the board. And all of you are on the board. See, it ain't like what happens, we got to elect the board. If you step on and want to protect kids and save schools, you on the Board of Education. Unlike what they want to do, I'll put you on the Board of Education 30 minutes every time they have a meeting every 2 weeks. Then you can't speak for 5 minutes, and then they don't record none of that.
Right.
It's a shame.
Here on this land where people can come and embrace the beauty.
the love
and solidarity.
Solidarity. Right. To be involved with children. So we collaborated with the College of Coastal Georgia to get some service learning projects for their anthropology class.
Right.
And we're also looking to do something along the lines of their American history class also.
Okay.
We can encourage the awakening that took place here,
right here,
and
exactly.
The culture that's within the, in the studies and the courses that they taught in the college.
Right. And you know, we have to get staff at the University of the Gullah Geechee Nation.
Yes.
And the Gullah Geechee Sea Otter Coalition Archive.
Right.
So we're definitely partnered with you because we do work with the University of North Florida with service learning projects.
Wonderful.
That are called transformational learning opportunities. So that you can bring the students up to us as well so they can get the real experience.
Yes.
Of the culture on the land in the rural environment. Then they understand, appreciate more.
Yes.
What happened with the building into what's now looking like a more urban environment.
Yes, that's it.
Yes.
That's it, Queen Quack.
Yes.
In a nutshell. That is exactly it.
Yes, so I appreciate you. Appreciate all the work y'all are doing. And we right here with you. Ain't leaving you. And like we always say, work together till us don't you get weary. But the great camp meeting in the promised land. And right here, this we promised land today, y'all excelled us. The libation pouring down. But it's love. It's nothing but love raining down from Francis to place. So you get a new day to find it where we to all work together and celebrate new culture. So
yes.
Thank God for you. So
thank
glad to see you, family.
And the family. I'm so glad to have my daughter back from college, who's also majored in psychology, and I'm working on my community psychology degree, and so we're going to collaborate and get this thing together for our community. And when we get it going, we're going to
still care for the children, and that's what it's about. And so, like I said earlier today, as a man or woman thinking, so is he and so is she. So our psychologists in our community are the ones who truly can understand our thought pattern and who we be. Not what other rest of people are calling, but who we know we be ourselves. So we thank you for our blessing. Y'all keep on the journey. It is a blessing to be back here with nothing but family. And other children know this year the Queen Quest, head for the body of the Gullah Geechee Nation, and this year it was wine. How are the children to do this year? The Queen Quest coming to Hunter Live once again for this year's Tunis Campbell celebration in Brunswick, Georgia, in the Gullah Geechee Nation. And we got the visionary behind this year's celebration in the Oakland and the Freedom School. We representative of the assembly representative for the Gullah Geechee Nation. We have Zach Line. How are they to do today?
Hunter to do real good today.
Glad to see this young wine.
I'm glad to be seeing too. I am one of the happiest black men you have ever seen in your life.
Okay, we like that. Because we know most of the time people think you are an angry black man.
So I am that now. Just because I'm smiling now, don't mean I ain't angry
okay.
Inside.
But
I'm boiling up.
But you're boiling up for the fight to educate our
kids. For the fight to educate our kids. We got a major purpose going with this Freedom School. And that is to protect our children and save our education for our schools.
Now, what gave you the idea to use the term Freedom School? Because I know some folks will say, well, that's a term because we bring it back from civil rights. But yet this is a Tunis Campbell celebration. So what made you come up with Freedom School?
Well, civil rights was a path that they used back in the 60s dealt with the notion of civil rights. That was something that made you feel that you had already got freedom.
Right, right.
Tunis Campbell was coming out of slavery, our people coming out of slavery, and he actually started Freedom School.
Right.
Him and Septima Clark carried it on
later on
during her educational run as an educator in the country.
Right.
So it was just a natural fit for us to try to carry on that legacy.
Absolutely.
At this time in history, because it's absolutely necessary that we educate our children and we educate them around the idea of freedom.
Right. And so when we focus in the Gullah Geechee Nation, as you know, as leaders, our focus is self-determination. And self-determination takes you a step further to freedom because it goes beyond civil rights. You're now talking about your natural born human right to existence. Now, how are you connecting that in terms of your
of the Freedom School?
Well, the first thing that happened with the curriculum with the Freedom School is that you mentioned the foundation of any freedom, and that's self-determination and self-preservation. And that was exactly the position that Tunis Campbell took when he was over the Outer Islands as superintendent, working away from you, working as you so eloquently put it this morning, Queen. He came to us first. Of course he came out of Port Royal. I'm glad that the man had sense enough to come through South Carolina before he came here, because there is nobody in Georgia that we could point to with the kind of courage that came out of South Carolina. Denmark Vesey, Gullah Jack, the Stono River Rebellion.
Yeah.
These things are traditions that we should never forget.
Right.
But everybody seems to want to forget it, push it under the table, and if we didn't know that we wanted to be free.
Right.
In fact, there's a rumor that goes around that says that Mrs. Harriet Tubman said that if we knew that we was in slavery, she could have got many more people out. Are you kidding? You know that we knew we was enslaved.
Right. But the whole thing is, even now, even in that context, some people would say, well, what he need a school. What he mean, he need to educate people. Folks go to school, they get the education. So isn't it the same kind of psychosis that Harry was really saying, and others had known they were slaves, I could have freed more? But the fact is, if you accept the state you're in as being normal, you don't see no place you gotta run to. Isn't that what we're dealing with?
Well, we're dealing with movement that is absolutely necessary in this time, because first of all, my friend and the late Dr. John Hope Franklin put it best. He said, I am going to always respect Sister Harriet, but I'm not going to put her before honoring something that happened that people want to wash over. And that is the fact that 55,000 of our people ran every year. Nobody didn't have to tell them where the North Star was, put no gun upside their head, beg them to leave. And as you well know, most of them ran to the South, to Haiti. They weren't fool enough to know that they had to go through all of those slave catching
states.
That propaganda has been the aim of the schools that we have allowed our children to be associated with. Propaganda is the problem, and now we are talking about intelligence. That's why we are named the Intelligent Advancement Movement as a community school board, because we are going to reshape the thinking of education of our young through our Freedom School.
Right, which stands for I am. Intelligence, all right? Y'all heard that? That's that first word. Advancement, moving that forward. All right, movement, the M, I am.
That's
and
right.
Interestingly enough, most of y'all know, and y'all hear me mention I am on the program, we have the I Am Museum we're building in Charleston, South Carolina. So once again, we're continuing this story in the Gullah Geechee Nation of the Carolina connection, the Georgia connection, and how spiritually we are always united in terms of seeking freedom, in terms of how we go about it. And the biggest thing is the mind, all right? Because as a man or woman thinking, so are they. So wanna think free, wanna be free. That's what we Gullah Geechee, Dr. Buzzard, moving from St. Helena Island, wanna think free, wanna be free. So we are so thankful that you think about freedom, but you walk in it, you mind for it, you fight for it, and I am glad that I'm here for the opening of the freedom.
We are so grateful that you came, because without you, our ancestral relationship with our ancestors would have been a little bit more difficult. for us to make the connection. That spiritualness you talk about has got to be the major foundation of the component in which we start on this journey.
Oh, yes.
And if you had been here, I would have been probably one sad puppet.
That's all right.
You know what I'm saying? As the queen of the Gullah Geechee Nation, you have demonstrated to me that you're the most intelligent woman in the world, bar none. And because of the fact that your leadership, and that's one of the things that we're going to be talking about in our freedom school. We're going to be talking about this idea that what we need to do is stop this junk about women not being able to lead. That is a ridiculous idea, and we have to put that to rest. Men have put that out there. In fact, if you look at the politics of today, men have made a decision that they're going to do what a good friend of some folk called Eldridge Cleaver did. Eldridge Cleaver, in his book, Soul on Ice, I think
it was
bragging about the idea of raping women. That's ridiculous. That's what, but guess what? Because of that sickness, guess who's doing it now? Governors. Governors of states, legislators of states. That's why in our freedom school, we want women to stand up and stand out and understand that what they've done has brought us over to this point. Why should we do what other foolish people would do and reject them with the power and mind and the dedication and commitment that they've always demonstrated in saving their babies?
And see, and that's powerful, especially coming from a man in your age group. You understand what I'm saying? Because you have a lot of men in your age group who are the ones who forwarded the agenda.
Absolutely.
That the women were only, and you'll remember this quote, the only position for a woman in the movement is coffee.
That's right.
Remember that quote?
That's correct.
All right, now I hated that quote. And I had a hard time with Brother Stokely Carmichael for years. And later, he had to recant on that. He became Brother Kwame Ture.
Well, you know, his recanting did not filter over to Martin Luther King Jr. Because what happened is, in a slick way, they took the theology from the black church and aimed it at women and said, step back.
Yeah.
If Septima Clark had been put on the level that she was supposed to have been when she joined SCLC, her and Ella Baker, things would be better today.
Huh?
But what they did was, they put them in the background, who was the mind, who was the backbone, who was the workers in the movement, while they dressed up and went before the camera.
Right, exactly.
Okay, and we need to end that. That needs to come to an end so that what we can do is move forward.
Absolutely.
When one of us are not free, none of us are not free. And when we're looking for freedom for just the black men, that is a ridiculous position, because by having that division, we have the black men going to prison and the women having to handle the burden. That's right.
That's right. So definitely, y'all heard us say it earlier, work together, chillin', going to get married, great camp meeting in the promised land.
This is
the promised land.
Great camp meeting.
And I am glad that we are here to advance intelligence in our movement.
Amen.
Here in the Gullah Geechee Nation. And so we're proud the Freedom School to open up and things like that. And y'all know it'll be the Gullah Geechee Freedom School if you want it. I got something new with it. But we right here in the Gullah Geechee Nation and so glad that Hunter tuned in to We TV Station. And Hunter Tiller knows this year, the one wine. Peace and blessings.
That's it.